It was like 10 or 15, 20 runs needed on the finals, and the stadium started to chant Vande Mataram. Don't think about the result. It's a result that puts pressure on us. I think the soldier's life is much more difficult than a yo-yo test.
Welcome. It's a good time when you have the man who'll always be defined by those two words, Captain Cool, for us. Thank you so much for speaking to us, MS Dhoni. It's not very often that you do such things, don't you?
Very long time.
Very long time indeed. So it's a good time for us that you're speaking to us. So what's your idea of a good time?
Well, I feel for me most of the time is good time. Either you're learning or you're enjoying what you have learned. So it's not the ups and the downs, you know, you lose some, you win some. When you win, you celebrate. When you lose, you learn. So either ways, I'm having a good time.
So how do you keep yourself so cool? I mean, as you said, it's always, you're unfazed by good and bad. So how do you maintain that calm, cool exterior?
Very simple. Don't think about the result. It's a result that puts pressure on us. You know, what if this happens? What if we don't win the game? What if we don't get selected? But again, worry about the controllables, you know, and whatever the controllables are, we take care of it, we'll get the desired result. If we don't get the desired result, we'll improve. We'll change our plans, we'll execute better, and we'll get a chance to prove ourselves again. So, you know, that's what it is. Thinking about the result never gives you result. Yes, you may have a target in mind, but what is more important is to take care of the small steps in life, you know, what needs to be done, what I am supposed to do, what extra I can do, and you know, that will help us achieve the target.
And we are here together with Mr. Jean Mark for a very special occasion. Are you a watch guy? I mean, do you always keep, are you glued to the watch?
I'm not glued to the watch, but I love watches, you know, and it's a passion that started much later in my life. First it was the bikes, and there's a reason behind it, you know.
So what's the reason?
Money, you know, because when you start, you don't have enough money. So in India, like bikes, when you talk about bikes or motorcycles or super bikes, in the Western world, they're more about passion, speed, and everything. In India, it's more about commute. You know, it takes you from one place to the other place. If you're supposed to go, you can't always take the local transport, but it'll cost. So you have these motorcycles that have so much mileage that, you know, it doesn't put a burden on your pocket.
Yeah.
But watches was something that I started getting into much later. It was maybe close to 2005, 6. I'd already played for India. And that was a time, you know, with much more exposure. You start to learn about new things, and watches was, you know, that era where, you know, 2005, where I started getting into the watches.
And you're quite a fan of this brand, and this was the only watch you wore, and you were the only guy they wanted. So how did this collaboration happen?
Well, I've known about Panerai from a very long time, and during 2011 World Cup and much before that, when Gary Kirsten was our coach, we used to have Mike Horn on and off, you know, used to come interact with the team, and he was a brand friend, you call him brand friend, of Panerai, and that was the first time I actually saw a Panerai watch in person. And by in person, I mean where you can say, Mike, can I have a look at your watch? So you can take the watch, you can have a look, and I was very impressed. And that actually got me more inclined towards Panerai, and I started getting more into, you know, the history of Panerai and what it was known for. And I was pretty amazed with the fact that, you know, Panerai started as a equipment company for the Italian Navy. You know, they supplied diving equipments for the Italian Navy, and you know, I'm very passionate about the defense forces.
Of course.
You know, that actually brought me even more closer. And also the fact that, you know, always felt Panerai was very bold, and it was very confident about, you know, what it is, you know, unfazed about what people would say. And it has stuck to the heritage that it has. You know, it has a very long heritage. It has gone through the ups and downs. And, you know, that's what makes you more and more successful in life, when you go through the ups and the downs at the same time. So yes, you know, Panerai, I've known Panerai for a very, very long time as a brand, but I'm fortunate that, you know, today I'm one of the ambassadors, you know, when it comes to Panerai.
So you have merged two aspects of his personality, an officer, army, and the gentleman sport, cricket. You brought that together.
Exactly.
Have you seen him play?
Well, I got the chance to meet with MS Dhoni in April for the first time, and he invited me to one of his matches, which he won. I think he did that on purpose. And it was a beautiful moment because it was my first match of cricket in my life. I was informed about the rules of the game by him before, but especially by his wife. So I had the best of his staff to take care of me during the match.
And are you a cricket convert? Let me ask you that first. Are you a cricket convert now?
Now I have seen the ambience and how much it generates passion in India, and the beauty of having met with MS Dhoni is that Mike Horn is one of our good ambassadors since many years. He spoke to me about MS Dhoni and about India that he has been many times. And when coming here, I discover his story from when he was a kid to today, and the success story that he represents. And for me, Panerai is in the same mood. MS Dhoni has mentioned rightfully that the brand has started and then was not anymore existing, taken over by Richemont in 1997, and is today one of the top 15 brands in the world. And this is a little bit the story of success story that MS Dhoni has also lived himself, and by being a long run fighter on developing his business. And I love his philosophy about not being obsessed by results. You know, this type of distance you can get, which requires a lot of self-confidence, because it's not given to everybody to have this type of distance to the actuality. And I think that his rules for him can apply also in the way we manage business.
Also, there were any moment in time that, since you're talking time, that you can never forget. It's just there. Can never forget that moment.
There's few instances in life, and I won't say it was the World Cup. You know, it was related to the World Cup. So, you know, one was when, after the 2007 World Cup, when we came back, the T20 World Cup, and we were on Marine Drive, our bus. We had a from the airport till Wankhede Stadium, we were supposed to come in a double decker open bus. And right in the middle, the whole bus is standing and can see loads of people on either side of the road. Out of their car, there was no one on the driving seat. Everybody is out, they have their mobiles out, and they have a big smile on their face. You don't even know how many of them would have missed their flights, but the kind of smile they had on their face at that point of time. And Marine Drive, you can see the full road from one end to the other, and it was filled with people. So that was one. The second was during the 2011 World Cup, and it was like 10 or 15, 20 runs needed on the finals, and the stadium started to chant Vande Mataram. And I believe, you know, that was something. I don't get goosebumps. I don't know. Maybe something wrong with me. I don't get goosebumps. But, you know, that moment, I don't think I would ever be able to get into a similar atmosphere. You know, there was something very beautiful about it. And when they started to chant, and let's say if it was moving from one side of the stadium to the other, your ears, they would actually move. And I feel that was awesome. Again a moment, you know, I would never forget in life. If I would ever get a chance to relive it, you know, definitely I would love to, but you know, that's not really in my control.
Awesome. But if you were to design a watch, would you put one little thing in it, like a time capsule, that could take you back to that moment?
We work on this movement, but it's not yet on. We work on it.
It will be very difficult. Huh? But imagine then you'll have somebody, maybe your kid or my kid, you know, will be like going back to the same time. It will be like a loop. You know, so you don't want that. You always want people to take care of the present so that their future is beautiful.
True. So what is tougher, morning 4G PT drills or Team India's yo-yo test? What is tougher?
I think the daily schedule of a soldier is tough. Yo-yo test happens once in 2 months, 3 months, and you know, I feel it's not something very difficult to achieve. You know, 16.1 is what the target is. It's not something that is very difficult to achieve. Soldier's life, I feel, you know, it's very demanding. And whether you are in peace posting or you are in the, you know, the LOC or the front line, you know, that also has an impact on the schedule that you have got. So nothing is easy. You know, often when you are at the LOC, you think peacekeeping, you know, when you are more inside is better. But once you are there, then a lot of fitness and everything is, it's a constant, you know, it keeps on happening. So I think the soldier's life is much more difficult than a yo-yo test.
Okay, I'm going to wrap up. They're all looking at me. Are you a PUBG fan?
No.
Okay, last question. You are the king of Ranchi, but also Chennai's Thala. How much do the fans matter to you, especially the Yellow Army?
Well, if you see, Tamil Nadu has literally adopted me. Ranchi, I come from Ranchi, so you know, big fan following over there. But I don't want to be unfair. Somehow wherever I've been, whichever team I've represented, the fans have always come and they have always supported us, irrespective of where I have played. So I would love to thank all of them. You know, whether it's Ranchi, whether it's Tamil Nadu, whether it's Mumbai, Delhi, everywhere. You know, we like personally they have really helped me throughout my cricketing career. So I won't be biased, but yes, Tamil Nadu has adopted me. Even people who don't watch cricket over there, you know, it's not like everybody watches cricket, but if they don't watch cricket, still they know about me and they love me.
And lastly, someone who is so fit, has a fitness regime, is conscious about his diet, which is one desi thing that you really crave whenever you are, wherever you are, your pleasure or your indulgence?
You know, it's not something that's very big. I would say it's the tea. You know, because tea comes with sugar. So I'm slightly old school. So, you know, after practice, we would have tea. Before practice, given a chance, we'll have tea. So tea is something that is very close to us. Maybe we are that generation.
Sure.
And that would be the guilt, you know, because a lot of sugar comes with tea. And whenever you are offered, you know, when I go to the stadium for my gym and all there, they offer me, let's have a cup of tea. It's like very difficult to say, you know, when you are asked for a gulab jamun or jalebi, you know, you're straight away like, no, I don't want to have it. Tea, you are like, acha, let's have it. There's something about it.
True. And thank you so much. And I hope there are many more occasions to speak to you. Thank you so much for getting him
thank
to
you.
Us. And well, pick up that watch. It looks cool, just like our captain cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.